put to the test. You know, we saw Kevin Oak put up a world record build yesterday, Brandon Allen. They had red lights throughout the day.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the way it should be. I mean, we're not perfect. So you need to be called fairly, and it's such a simple thing. It's argued to death on the internet, the spot depth. So simple to see. And it's like I was talking to Steve Goggins. If you watched the meet like yesterday, it was such a great meet. And there's very little controversy about it. You know, just call it right, and the numbers will be big. You know, guys will adjust. That's what I feel about it.
Does this make you want to lift watching this competition? Are you know, fired up?
Anytime I'm around strong guys, I mean, I'm driven to lift internally, but when I'm around strong people at a good meet, it only kicks the fire up for sure. But, you know, I have a special tie to this meet. 2 years ago when I fell, you know, I have some redemption coming for this stage. Maybe 2017.
You going to come back here? This platform?
I told Steve today that, you know, I'm having a surgery Tuesday. We're going to clean my knee out again. I'm stronger than I've ever been right now. I'm 100% putting my focus on this meet right here. So, you know, I kind of conquered the squat that took me down in the gym. Now I got to do it on the platform. And what a better platform than this one. So,
you got to settle some business internally with yourself right here.
It is, man. It's one of those things. It's kind of like a sore at the top of your mouth or something. It always bugs you. You know, you can't get rid of it. No.
How's your training going right now? I mean, other than
you know, I had surgery 8 months ago. For 2.5 months, I did absolutely nothing. Just let my body kind of decompress and heal. Coming back from that, I started training again. My training was so boring. Like, I had one commitment, and it was have fun. Go to the gym. Weight was irrelevant. The time I was in the gym was irrelevant. Just have fun. And,
get up!
Second and 10 by Short.
That's pretty amazing right there.
391.
It was sort of a 3 pound body weight spot. But, you know, I got back in the gym, doing a bunch of the boring stuff, high rep training, bodybuilding style stuff. And then when I started actually pushing my body a little bit into the 90-minute range, it felt good, you know, but I didn't jump straight to 100. I stayed there for a little while, came back down and went back up. I benched 575 on a self-handout, pulled 840, and I squatted 745 in DC for lockout. So, as strong as I've ever been.
Now, with having the knee bother you, did that really mess with your bench when you started benching again?
I've never been a guy that had a lot of leg drive anyway. KK gave me some advice one time. He said, if you get your arm stronger, your bench will go up. So, you know, I kind of took that mentality and ran with it. This is one of my guys. He's training the cube right here.
Scott Brewer.
Oh, get up.
No lift.
It's a bad advertisement. Let's go back in it. But he's a good guy. He trains out of Grayson's gym. But, yeah, you know, having the quad issue, the quad tendon issue, I couldn't train the same way. So I had to back up. My deadlift started becoming more hamstring and glute dominant. My squat started becoming more glute and hamstring dominant. Numbers went up. So I'm hoping that when I come back with a whole quad, things can need to go even further so that I can put all the pieces together. But as much as a negative that it was, I've really learned a lot in the sport about myself and then outside as a business person, a father, you know, just a person. You know, it challenged me in all those areas.
So that injury did just affect you physically.
You know, I gotta have the blinders on. It was powerlifting or nothing. You know, I went all into that. And then when I no longer had the powerlifting, when the powerlifting was gone, what am I? Who am I? You know, and I let myself really backing away. And just taking a look at where my life was and the kind of person that I was like, you know what? Powerlifting won't be around forever, but I need to invest in things that will. And it gave me a balance. And now, like I said, I'm just as strong as ever. I'm just as involved in the sport as ever, but I can shut it off, you know? And that's, for me, that's been a big change.
Outside of powerlifting and being a family, what else do you do?
I work with the University of Kentucky. Despite what people might think, I have a 9-to-5 job. I work with them in the football team, strength and conditioning. Very, very small on the basketball. But I stay busy there. I own a couple other businesses. One is, you know, training online. And then I have some properties that are owned. I got hired to fire, and it allows me, it's a lot of responsibility, but it allows me to travel in events like this. I'm not tied to a desk job necessarily. UK is really, really good about encouraging me about staying involved in powerlifting as well as being involved in this.
Regardless of what people think, I mean, there are not people that are born that are just great at it. They have to work to go from good to great. They may be good and better than most people to start because of their leverages and how they comprehend how to work the mechanics. The hard work, that trumps everything.
Well, look at Brandon Allen. He's a perfect example. I met him 2 or 3 years ago right here.
Right.
He was 280, 290, you know. And he told me, backstage, he said, I want to meet you. And, you know, if a guy says that to me, I respect him. You know, you're going to have to earn it. You're going to have to beat me. But that's the same mentality I have, you know. And he's put in the work. I mean, he's gotten massive. He's eating crazy. He's training hard. Paid off, 2,300 pound total.
Yeah, that's a good
idea. How do you argue with that?
I was asking Steve Goggins, I said, watching his performance yesterday, how would you put him up against some of the super heavyweights in their prime? And he said, oh man, him and David Douglas both would give the guys of his prime a run for their money, too.
You know, in the past few months, I've gotten close to Bill Kazman. I visited up to Alaska and got to spend some time with him. And as much as you can compare and contrast, those guys had their era, we've got our era, and we'll be talking about somebody 10 years from now. That's otherworldly, you know what I mean? But the fact of the matter is, strong recognizes strong.
All right, and this guy's all the way from the Keystone.
I definitely think Brandon could compete with anybody, anywhere.
This lift is inhuman. He weighs 100.
When I come to meets like this one, I get excited. You know, this the internet can really make you hate powerlifting. But when you're here and you see the people and you talk to lifters, it's impossible not to get excited about it. Yes.
Getting Malik ready to go. Malik trying to add to his total at Worlds. Malik totaled 1,900 classic qual, which was an all-time world record at 181.
Pretty good day.
Yeah, for anybody, regardless of 180.
You know, we were just talking about that backstage.
I understand, suffered a hand injury, but like, the
3 to 4 years ago, everybody was like, man, 2,000 is a huge total.
I mean, this is more like, so much of your
2,000 is still a huge total, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like there are more people doing it. But I had a kid one time message me, and he was like, I just have a 2,000 pound total.
All right,
let's break that down. 750 squat, 500 bench, 750 deadlift. You do any of that, and you're strong. You know what I mean? To do all three in one day, 2,000 is massive, man.
It is.
And then and some of the lighter guys, you know, a Richard Hawthorne kind of guy, you know, 10, 11 times body weight, what the hell? Maybe even 12.
Yeah. Big squat right here.
For Malik.
Wow.
A good lift. Nice work.
I started powerlifting 15 years ago, I never looked at weight classes. I looked at how strong can I be, and whatever I weigh is what I'm going to eat at. If I'm a couple pounds over, I might think about it. But when I just work with people, I tell them, don't even think about weight classes. It's just going wrong.
Yeah, you know, it's like this. If you get your ass kicked in a bar fight, you don't justify it because, oh, well, he was so much bigger. No, you just got your ass kicked. You know what I mean? I get it for the aspect of competition, having the weight classes and everything. But I always encourage people to lift more weight. And then if you're worried about a weight class, get them to, like, do your cut later. Hit the number first. You know, like Kevin, I think he hit 2,100 at 242. And then he knew his body was capable of it. Now it was, let's do it at 2,200, 2,220.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So if people want to purchase training from you, how do they do that? How do they go
about? Well, I got two things going on right now. Cube Cartel is a training app. And it's really cool. Very interactive. I put in the workouts every single week. The more information you plug in about your lifting and the style of lifting, the more personalized it gets to you. It is a generalized program, but the more information you give, the more precise it gets to you. And then you can do that through trainheroic.com, and you can sign up that way, Cube Cartel, or you can contact me at lilytraining.yahoo.com.
I just want you to move the camera a little. That one. Yeah, just get it centered on them.
You want to turn it for me?
Is it this one right here?
Yeah, it's that one.
These will be our third and final attempts for...
A little bit more.
There we go.
Good?
Yeah.
Got some technical difficulties there.
I'll get it.
Probably. Yeah.
Just run up there and wave your dog.
I love it. I get people to stand in front of the camera and I'll go, oh, don't worry, there's a camera there. Yeah. You know, it's not live or anything. Yeah, I would think, you know, I saw you walk around and I said to myself, man, I was here 2 years ago when that happened to you. I was at the base of the platform. And I remember thinking, you're going to come back here one of these days and you're going to settle business with yourself. And then you're probably going to take a moment to yourself afterwards, go in a corner somewhere and settle.
Oh, listen. When I squatted the 745 the other day in the gym, I didn't do anything else. I stripped the bar, talked about drugs.
Shorty, let's go!
And it was like 2 years hit me.
Yeah.
You know, and that's when, I mean, I'm not going to listen to anything, but all I wanted to do was get better. You know, if that meant 300 pounds fun, that's fine. If that meant a 400 pounds fun, that's fine. I just wanted to continue to get better. And I set my truck and I thought about all the surgeries, all the ups and downs. And in that moment, it was like, oh, it didn't even matter anymore. You know,
it was a great thing.
413 in the squat, 343 in the squat. We're on third attempts now. We've got about 8 lifters to go, and that'll complete this flight. We have in the super heavyweights.
Oh, you got some big, big boys coming up here in a minute.
Big, big lifts. Yeah, I was thinking, man, this has got to fire you up, you know, because even though your injury set you back, there's nothing else for you. This is what you do.
Yeah, absolutely.
You being
I'm
here,
a lifer, you know.
This really wakes you up. This is going to give you more motivation. Even though you're already internally motivated, this is just going to throw a little bit more gasoline in your fire.
Let's go, Scott. As busy as she is, lifting at the level she is, I mean, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
And it's an investment. You can see her again. She knows every lifter. She knows their lift. as a coach and watching him over and over and over again, I don't know what broke down there for him specifically, but, you know.
It's going to happen on Thursday. Yeah, it's going to come out whole, either you get it or not.
You know, I think a lot of guys can fall into a trap of what they want versus what is there.
What is realistic.
You know, and your training will tell you what's there. Now, the only time that you go for what you want is on a deadlift, on the third deadlift, when a win comes down to it. You might have to reach it over 5-10 kilos to figure out if you can do it or not. But you know, that's when it matters. That's a die, I'm popping my ass off.
6:33. Want some water?
Apparently I swallowed some chalk or something.
6:33 on the bar for Damon Myers. Steve Gockins has got his coaching eyes on.
What?
He's got his coaching eyes on.
Oh, yeah. Steve's the man. Guys to mono really benefit from walking out weights up until 70-80%. You know, you need to put some time on your tension prospects. And then, you know, when you get to do your big weights, use the mono for a safety reason or whatever. But this is the way our sport started. I don't think that the walkout should ever go away. You know, I think you get too far away from your roots. You know, people ask me all the time, do I blame anybody for my fall? I blame myself. Those guys would have caught my lip, and I know the danger of playing the game. You know what I mean? So if they had caught me, I might have done a little less damage. But you know what? It had already popped, I think, when I started to fall. So I was falling no matter what.
It was going to happen, but like we talked about earlier, now looking back on it, it may have been one of the best things that ever happened to
me. I will tell you, as a lifter and someone who understands the sport, the best thing that ever happened. Because before, I was a bull. I bulled through everything. I relied on my strength, my ability to just power through. And with an injury, you really have to think, what am I doing? How is this affecting my body? How does this affect tomorrow? You know, what I'm doing today, how does it affect tomorrow? So it's really changed the way I think about a lot of things. Well, listen, I got to bounce. I got to keep warming up.
Thank you for your time.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you guys for tuning in. You know, anybody that's watching, it's important that you guys keep the sport going. And for all you people out there that are just watching the troll, suck.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, man.
Keep up the good work. Brandon Lilly. Brandon Lilly. He's a good man. Had some life changes.